Choral Evensong is the first of three specially recorded for the BBC in St. Thomas's Church, New York. St. Thomas not only has its own choir school, but also maintains a pattern of sung services similar to many English cathedrals. And here to tell you about the church and its music is the rector, the Reverend Dr. John Andrew.
In the heart of Manhattan, New York, is one of the busiest streets in the world, Fifth Avenue. The front steps of St. Thomas Church are on Fifth Avenue at 53rd Street, pretty well exactly in Midtown. Skyscrapers are on three sides of it, and they dwarf this limestone Gothic building, the masterpiece of its architects, Ralph Adams Cram and Bertram Goodhue. But once inside, the arches of the roof soar upwards, and one of the loveliest carved stone altar screens in the world, the reredos, with all its saints and angels, reaches to the roof. And below me as I stand, 90 feet, underneath this church, is the subway, and you may hear the trains rumbling as I talk to you. It's a noble place, but it's something else. It houses the best church music in the United States, with a musical tradition and a choir school begun by a former organist and master of choristers of York Minster, Dr. Tertius Noble, over 60 years ago. You're shortly to hear our choir of about 12 men and 26 boys, members of an institution unique on the continent of the Americas, a resident choir school, whose headmaster, Mr. Gordon Clem, and organist and master of choristers, Mr. Gerre Hancock, have, in a partnership of 11 years, made the standards very high. There's a lot of American church music which you may not have heard before, and we are bringing some of it to you in these broadcasts. We are, incidentally, the first American choir to broadcast from our church in this series. It happens that they have an Englishman as rector, not an American. Rather a speckled egg here in New York. Put me down as one of the accidents of history. But this accident was brought up as a chorister and loves church music with a passion. Moreover, Gerre Hancock and his wife Judith and I happen to be great friends, and it makes our work fun as well as exciting. I hope you'll enjoy listening to Evensong as much as we, so many thousands of miles away from you, have enjoyed offering this sung praise to God.
Lord is in his holy temple, let all the earth keep silence before him. God opened our ears.
And our mouths shall shout thy praise.
For God makes speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is God, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
Psalms appointed for the ninth evening, 47 and 49.
Yeah.
Here beginneth the third chapter of the book of Numbers. These also are the generations of Aaron and Moses in the day that the Lord spake with Moses in Mount Sinai. And these are the names of the sons of Aaron: Nadab, the firstborn, and Abihu, Eleazar, and Ithamar. These are the names of the sons of Aaron, the priests which were anointed, whom he consecrated to minister in the priest's office. And Nadab and Abihu died before the Lord when they offered strange fire before the Lord in the wilderness of Sinai, and they had no children. And Eleazar and Ithamar ministered in the priest's office in the sight of Aaron their father. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, Bring the tribe of Levi near, and present them before Aaron the priest, that they may minister unto him. And they shall keep his charge, and the charge of the whole congregation before the tabernacle of the congregation, to do the service of the tabernacle. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, And I, behold, I have taken the Levites from among the children of Israel, instead of all the firstborn that openeth the matrix among the children of Israel. Therefore the Levites shall be mine, because all the firstborn are mine. For on the day that I smote all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, I hallowed unto me all the firstborn in Israel, both man and beast. Mine shall they be. I am the Lord. Here endeth the first lesson.
Thank you. Here beginneth the 24th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Jesus was leaving the temple when his disciples came and pointed to the temple buildings. He answered, "Yes, look at it all. I tell you this, not one stone will be left upon another, all will be thrown down." When he was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to speak to him privately. "Tell us," they said, "when will this happen, and what will be the signal for your coming and the end of the age?" Jesus replied, "Take care that no one misleads you, for many will come claiming my name and saying, 'I am the Messiah,' and many will be misled by them. The time is coming when you will hear the noise of battle near at hand and the news of battles far away. See that you are not alarmed. Such things are bound to happen, but the end is still to come. For nation will make war upon nation, kingdom upon kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in many places. With all these things, the birth pangs of the new age begin. You will then be handed over for punishment and execution, and men of all nations will hate you for your allegiance to me. Many will fall from their faith. They will betray one another and hate one another. Many false prophets will arise and will mislead many. And as lawlessness spreads, men's love for one another will grow cold. But the man who holds out to the end will be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be proclaimed throughout the earth as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come." Here endeth the second lesson.
Thank you.
protector of all that trust in thee, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy. Increase and multiply upon us thy mercy, that thou, being our ruler and guide, we may so pass through things temporal, that we finally lose not the things eternal. Grant this, O Heavenly Father, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desire, all good counsels and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thine only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ.
Lear Sowerby, who was the composer of the Magnificat and Nunc Dimitti settings tonight, composed a setting to an anthem, I Was Glad When They Said Unto Me. Sowerby was the organist of St. James's Cathedral in Chicago and associated with our national cathedral in Washington, D.C. The anthem, I Was Glad.